getting executives together from across the country with health leaders and industry leaders about the future of healthcare. So we really want to do a number of round tables, bring people together across the nation to get a new conversation going about how digital transformation can occur in healthcare and be more sustainable for both healthcare service delivery, but also personalised care.
The data for me is probably the most important piece around how you drive innovation, how you drive security, how you drive patient care, and it's a collaboration of all of those aspects, and how all the hospitals actually share that information together, I think is the critical piece.
Doctors and clinicians are always patient-centric. The problem is that it's their patient. And what we've got to do is actually open it up, get the continuum of care, get the coordination of care. We need innovation about how we can put information in different clinical settings and for different people to actually do what they need to do.
Health has been innovative throughout its life cycle, but it hasn't really been innovative in bringing those to system and scale in terms of the problems it faces now. So it doesn't matter whether it's the chronic end and the use of decent innovation to make a difference to cost, value and outcome at end of life, or whether it's the front end of the scale where there is so much happening in consumer spaces that we just don't get into health at all, where everything from electronic funds transfer to stays and Uber and Airbnb equivalents, that people can take some real responsibility for their own health and minimise the cost of the system. We have literally no way to bring those sorts of innovations into the system and no way to scale them when they do.
As cybersecurity has become a major topic, it struck me that I have to protect the kids. And the best way to do that is to get more engaged and more involved. And so when the cybersecurity opportunity came available, I thought, you know, that's something I would really like to be involved in, because again, it's about educating our leadership about how important security is, but on the other hand, making sure that data and information is available to actually take care of the patient. So it's a delicate balance between being very secure and having nothing happen and not letting terrible things happen because of cybersecurity. It's things we've never had to worry about.
The problems with health and the problems with human services from an innovation perspective are just enormous. These are both fields that are mired in legacy effects, that where innovation is expensive and difficult, the productivity gains are difficult. And what's interesting is that when you put the two together, it actually becomes an easier problem to solve than seeing them separately because of the way that you can introduce new technologies into the space.
There seems to be a divergence around the use of wearables and digital devices that empower patients not only to monitor their wellness, but also their vital signs if they have a chronic disease. These are the kind of devices which the Internet of Things will enable patients to become much more empowered in their healthcare decision making.
We always view security as trying to stop you doing something. You know, it's always in the way or you have to do something, but actually we should be looking at it and flipping it the other way around and saying, okay, well, how do we make security in that? How does it help us get information, not how does it stop us?
And how we can bridge this gap between having this knowledge from research and these great innovations and that getting put into practice in a way that's much quicker. At the moment we know that there's around a 17-year gap between what we know from health research and what we do. We also know there's mounds of reading that clinicians would have to do to be on top of things. So it's sort of how can we make that a little bit easier, and particularly given that we have so much technology, we have access to so much data these days, and how we can do things a little faster using some of that technology and maybe close this gap a little bit faster, particularly in Australia, would be great.